Hello, this is Noblesville High School Jazz Ensemble. My name is Bethany Robinson, and today we will be playing Tall Cotton by Sammy Nestico, Flirty Bird by Duke Ellington, and also by Duke Ellington, Portrait of Louis Armstrong.
Thank you. Noblesville High School. My name's Wilbur Whitman. I'm going to be discussing with you some of the great things that I heard on your video recording that you submitted for the National Jazz Festival Virtual Division. You are really one of the benchmark bands that we have participating in the National Jazz Festival. It's a terrific set of tunes. The soloing is strong. The blend and balance is very, very, very mature. And I have some, suggestions that I'd like to give you, but I just want to let you know right off there, I hope your school and I hope your community is as proud of you as I am and we are here at the National Jazz Festival. You are really one of the benchmark bands in the country, and I hope the comments that we give you, you can work hard toward and help you even become better. And we sure love to get you here live so we can hear you in the same room, be in the same room with you. So some of the comments I have to do with inflection and bringing that, talk about the things that you already are doing, but maybe I would like you to do a little more of. One thing is in the bassy tune, the smear of the sound on, I think you guys did the Tall Cotton, right? Yeah. The smear of the sound in the saxophones. It's not Marshall Royal playing. I put the link to the album. I've played that chart with Butch Miles from the Basie band, and Steve Turay actually played the trombone part when I was with him. And so I from sitting, in front of the band and hearing those that from people that have played in the Basie band, with that I can help you with it. The saxophones are doing the smear. It's just that it's not long enough. At times, the smear connects from measure to measure of different areas, and I highlighted them in the time on your sheet so you could listen back, because I didn't just want to say it and not do it. I literally went back again and am redoing some things to let you see exactly, make it clear, because you guys did your homework so well. The other thing was also in the drummer, Butch kicks it more. At times, in a number of places. I think you're the same, the band with the portrait of trumpet too, right? At the end there, let me make sure. Portrait of Louis, when the trumpet goes da, 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 and he goes up to, the high note, let's say it's high C. You whack that with him. It adds to that percussive sound, adds to it. And, there's those opportunities there, because you're a great timekeeper and you couldn't play the charts without you guys being on that level. So, these are things that are above and beyond, that, because, I have you as a gold rated band, if you call that, but, numbers shouldn't matter when you're in a band like you with those guys. I appreciated the quotes and the soloing too. I think I heard either Ornithology or about the Charlie Parker thing was in one of them in there too. And some of the other tactics too that Butch did. Sometimes you can play on the side of the hi-hat too, or and do rim clicks on 2 and 4. I didn't hear any of that, and that usually locks a sax solo in. He would do that a lot on sax solo. Maybe in the sax solo, he might do it on 4, just beat 4, to click. And sometimes on the high hat, the hi-hat and the hi-hat too on the sax cymbal on 2 and 4 on the stand, not the cymbal part, on the stand. So those little slick things in there. There's, if you could find some recordings to listen to of John Riley from the Vanguard band, the old Thad Jones-Malouis band, the Vanguard band. Did a CD recording when I was editing with him. I could hear right before an attack, there was like a swoosh. It was like, and the band come in, pop, and you'd hear right before it, you'd hear, swap. It was like swap. It was like he was able to do that, and it's a little technique on the snare drum. It's a slide of the stick on that. I asked him how he did that, so I would know on that. And that's another. These are those little techniques that add to the make the that make your kit talk kind of thing, like with those. But the teaching, the level of teaching that's going on at this school is just makes my heart feel good. I was, teacher, colleges and middle school for 32 years. So seeing you guys grow up and play like this and swing and, it's just terrific for me. The drummer I'm talking about is Butch Miles, right? That's the guy from the Basie Band. And again, the lead alto on that recording of Tall Cotton is not Marshall Royal, but that doesn't matter. I've heard him play before, and the smear, it just needs more connection and be able to smear longer. I think it's just a little too lighter. It's just not enough. You could have more of that. Well, thanks so much for being part of the festival again. And it's great to hear you. I know you were here last year, and you did terrific. It's great to hear, you again. Maybe a little more bass too. I think I talk about that on there. The clarity of the bass. Have you guys ever tried moving the bass up and playing acoustically? I've seen some bands around the country now have done that, like the old Basie Band for recordings. The bass would be up front, and when the soloist had a solo, they'd come up front too, in front of the two mics that they're using to record, right? And when the background figures got hotter, the soloist stepped up closer to the recording mic. So that like moving, I've seen this moving the bass, acoustic bass up, and even not having it mic'd, and then balancing your band around that is something you could practice and see how you like that. Do it. Again, that's something I'd like to hear in a live room. It's difficult when you're recording. Like you guys, seems like you're recording. The mics are maybe further back in the theater, the auditorium you're using. Appreciate the. I think you were the ones that used the grand piano, right? I hope so. Not the electric piano on the Basie thing, right? If not, use grand. The patch isn't very good if it was. So hope that helps you. Best wishes, and thanks for being one of really my favorite bands this season.